that 4 or 5 yards away, and he was looking around, all puzzled. And I said, "What's the matter with you, mate? You lost somebody?" He said, "I lost my wife." And I said, "Well, I have as well." I said, "They're in here somewhere." I said, "Shall we look for them together? Look for our wives together." He said, "Oh." And I said, "Now, hang on." I said, "I don't know what your wife looks like. Can you describe her?" He says, "Well, she's about 35 years old." He says, "She's wearing a very high miniskirt. And has got a very low-cut blouse and is pretty well built. And has got very high-heel shoes and black stockings. And she's got lovely long blonde hair all down her back. And she's very heavily made up." And I said, "Okay, I'll see." He says, "What's yours look like?" I said, "Well, I'll tell you what." I said, "Let's concentrate on yours."
Loved singing at school, and we had first of all it was a lady, and then Arthur Woodall. He was a great pianist. He was lovely, and he taught us all sorts of things.
1955, we moved from a little semi-detached in Belvale up to Drew's Holloway, to a place called Greengates, which was owned originally by the Atwood family, who were big solicitors in Cradleith, and then D&F Fellows, one of the people from there. Lovely big house, had a lovely tennis court at the back, and then it was renamed by my mother Burford House, because all of her mother's side all came from Burford in the Cotswolds, you see. So hence the Burford, it was Burford House. My dad and mum were both very good singers. In fact, my mum passed the audition for Covent Garden later on. They had a big circle of friends, very musical. My dad originally came from number 2 Alma Street in Cradley. So he'd never lived anywhere in his life except Cradley. Never moved out of Cradley at all in the whole of his life. He knew Bruce Dargable, who was one of the principal baritones of Covent Garden Opera, and also Murray Dickey, who was one of the top tenors of Covent Garden Opera, who would actually sing at the Royal Opera House in Rome and the New York Metropolitan, the greatest opera houses in the world. And my dad got these blokes to come to Colligate Providence Methodist Church Hall and sing. I mean, you can just imagine the talk in Covent Garden, saying, "Oh, I'm going to Metropolitan New York next week. Where are you going?" "Oh, I'm singing at Colligate Providence Methodist Church." So it's a bit unbelievable in a way, but they actually came and sang, and my mother sang the sort of duets with them.
I was in the Stourbridge Ladies Choir, and that's where outside singing started. I really enjoyed that. We used to put big concerts on and have lovely singers, you know, out front, and I always wanted to do that.
My dad and mum also took the lead in the local operatic society, Stourbridge Operatic, and they formed the Gilbert and Sullivan Club with some other people.
And so I've really always been doing something on the stage.
He wanted to get a bit more commercial, so he got a bunch of about a dozen girls who he knew from the operatic societies and formed the Burford Singers. Now, this must have been in the late 50s, I think. Yes, in the mid to late 50s, because they used to be rehearsing in the front room, in a big lounge of Burford House, and my little skiffle group were rehearsing in the living room, and the two sounds were sort of quite different, you know.
Ashley Pegg, Bev's father, he was the one that introduced me to bigger music, and it was my life to go down every Tuesday night down to Burford House and sing.
And the Burford Singers were very good, and they actually did a lot of cabarets and Masonic and Rotary functions all around the area, and they actually appeared on Opportunity Knocks with Huey Green, and they did quite well in that. They didn't win it, but they went far away, and I remember they were on the same bill as Freddie Parrotface, or whatever his name was, who won it, you know.
And he took us all over the place. Everywhere. I mean, we've been wonderful places. Been on television, sang at the Alec, been on the Alec with all the big stars. And Ashley and Nora, his wife, she was wonderful to me. She used to look after me.
The Burford Singers were the main outfit that my dad had doing all these things, you know, based in Cradley, but going all around the Midlands, you know.
We did sing with the Providence Singers. We made a lot of money for the Acorn Hospice and Mary Stevens. I was more for the music.
And I went into W.H. Smith and I said to the lady behind the counter, I said, excuse me, but do you sell bereavement cards? And she says, yes, we do, actually. I said, well, is it possible I could swap this Get Well card I bought yesterday?